Okay, we're going to work on a percent mixture problem using one variable. So here's a problem. How many pounds of dog food, that is 50% rice, so that means half of the dog food is pure rice, must be mixed with 400 pounds of dog food, that is 80% rice, to make a dog food that is 75% rice? So the idea is we're taking two different concentrations of dog food, and by concentrations that means how much of it is pure rice, and we're trying to make something where the rice is somewhere in between. So here's the picture. We've got two dog foods here, and we're going to pour them together into this bigger bin, right? So we're going to imagine we're going to take some dog food that is 50% rice and some other dog food that is 80% rice, and we're going to pour it into a large vat. Okay, so the question is, how much is in each vat? So we look to see if it tells us how much is in any of these vats. So it does say here 400 pounds, that is the 80% rice. So this 80% vat, in that we know we've got 400 total pounds of dog food. Now that does not mean it's all rice. Remember, only 80% of that is rice. And that's all it tells us, right? So the question is, how many pounds of the 50% dog food? And that's what we don't know. So we'll let that be our variable. Let's call that X. We don't know how much is here. But again, this is just a total amount of that package, not just the rice. So if I pour it together, that's what I've got in here. I've got X pounds plus 400 more pounds. So in this big vat, I have X plus 400 pounds. Now, let's now consider how much rice is in each of these vats. Well, notice this is the 50% vat. Writing that as a decimal, it's 0.50 or 0.5. 80%, I'm writing underneath that. I'm just writing the percent as decimals under each vat. So this is the amount of the actual bag, the amount of total food. But now I'm going to write out the amount of rice in each bag. Well, 50% of the bag is rice of this first one, so that's 0.50 times X. So that's how much rice is in this bag. Now, how much rice is in this bag? 80% of the 400, so that's 0.80 times 400. And how much is in this total vat then? I know I want to make it so it's only 75%. So instead of being 80%, it's only 75%, which is more than the 50%. You can guess there's going to be more of the 80%, right? Because it's only going down from 80 to 75. So this would be 70.75 times X plus 400. Okay. All right, so what we have is, that's how much rice is in each, right? But since we're pouring the rice, the pure rice that's in each vat together, the pure rice in the final should be the same. So if I add the pure rice from the first bag, and you imagine how much pure rice is in the second bag, you should end up with exactly the same amount of rice in the third bag. And this is your equation. So the equation comes from the amount of pure rice that is in each bag. So imagine, if you were going to look at the picture, let's say half of this is rice. Let's get a little picture of that. So I'm going to get highlighter, sorry. All right, so this is like about 50% rice, let's say. Let's say about half of it is rice, you can imagine. Then over here, it's like a lot more. It's like about 80%. So you can get a picture if the yellow part is how much is pure rice, right, out of the whole container. And in the end, it's about 75% rice. You could sort of see a picture. That's where we're getting our equation from, is how much pure rice is in each container. So you can't all of a sudden have more rice or less rice in the final container than there were in the original two. All right, so let's just think what we've done so far. We drew a picture of what's going on, and in that is where I'm really defining X. So if you want, you could write somewhere else that X is how much dog food you're using of 50%, or you could just draw a picture and it's clear that's what X stands for. And we fill in what we know in these three places. There'll be some unknowns, and then we to get the equation, it's the actual amount of rice. So the next step would be to solve this equation. Now, you can solve this equation by working with the decimals throughout the problem using a calculator. I like to multiply both sides of the equation by 100 to eliminate all of the decimals. And since 0.75 has two places after the decimal point, I'm going to multiply everything by 100. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 100, which means I'm multiplying 100 on the left side. And 100 on the right side. Now, when you're multiplying 100 times the 0.75, that'll take care of that decimal, but the x plus 400 does not also get multiplied. Alright, so what we have here is 100 times 0.50 will just now be 50x, and this will just be 80 times 400, and that'll be 75 times x plus 400. Now, when you write the original equation, you do need to have the decimal points. It really was percents. The only reason I could write it this way is because it's an equation, and I multiply both sides by 100. All right, so this gives me 50x plus 80 times 400. Well, that's 8 times 4, which is 32, and then the three zeros. And then we distribute the 75, so 75 times x is 75x, and 75 times 4, well, let's see, 75 times 2 is 150, times 2 again is 300, with the extra two zeros. Okay, so I've got each side simplified. And now we can put the variables on either side of the equation. I'm going to subtract 50x from both sides so that the x term will be positive. So if I subtract 50x from both sides, I've got the x terms on the right side of the equation, which will make a positive, right? And that means we don't want the 30,000 on this side, so I'm going to have to subtract 30,000 at the same time, if you want. And that'll give me 2,000. Alright, so the last thing to do is to divide both sides by 25. Alright, let's see, well, 25 goes into 208, so that's going to be 80. So x is going to be 80. Alright, so that's what I've got so far. Alright, now, you have to remember that that might not be the question they're asking for. We have to go back to the original equation, and I want to just point out, this original problem, you could have just done the distributive property using all the decimal points here and done everything with a calculator, and you should still get x equals 80. I just did it without a calculator by multiplying by 100. So our next step is go back to the problem, the original problem, and then we're going to draw a picture and see if this all makes sense again. Alright, so here was our original problem, how many pounds of dog food that's 50% rice must be mixed with 400 pounds of dog food that's 80% rice to make a dog food that's 75% rice, and this is how we set up our variable. We said x was in the 50%, 400 was in the 80%. So now we know what x is. Now we have to check our work. X was 80, and in our original picture we had put that with a 50% VAT, so we know what that is. So we've got 80 pounds and 400 pounds are mixing together. That means there must be 480 pounds over here. Now let's see how much rice is in each bag. So it says 50% of 80. So 50% of 80 is half of 80, or 40 pounds. In this bag, it's 80% of 400, so 0.8 times 400. That's 320. And in the mixture, we want 75%, 0.75 times 480. So that ends up being 360. So the question is, if you have this particular mix, 80 pounds, 400 pounds, and you mix it together, would you have the same amount of rice in the end? So the question is 400 plus 320 really the same thing as 360, which is what's in there? Yes, it is. So we answer the question. The question was, how many pounds of dog food that is 50% rice? There it is. We look at the picture, it's 80 pounds. So remember to write your answer in words. X isn't necessarily always going to be the answer. I hope you learned something. Remember.